Welcome back, guys. Olivia Rodrigo's newest album, Sour, is out. Now, the singles, I'm going to react to it in just a bit, but the singles, we have Driver's License, which is an absolute banger, one of the best lyric songs I have ever heard, maybe in my entire life, but definitely of the year. Deja Vu was another great track as well, and Good For You had more of a pop-punk vibe, Avril Lavigne kind of feeling to it, so we're going to definitely see all three singles sound super different. And this song's only 34 minutes, so we're going to react to the whole album. And let's do it. Sour. This first song's called Brutal, a new one. What?
I'm so insecure, I think, that I'll die before I drink. And I'm so caught up in the news of who likes me and who hates you.
Okay. I love the guitar on it.
God, it's brutal out here.
Yes, no way. Slowing down, okay. That was a good first intro track, was brutal. I definitely liked it. The lyrics were kind of just saying, get rid of all that pain, get rid of all that brutality that she has inside her. I really liked it. I love the guitar on it as well, the like choppy guitars. It was a really great start to the intro or the album. Just full on banger right away, you know what I'm saying? Getting people that this next one is called Traitor. Here we go. Nice little smooth piano going on here. Dang, that was powerful, man. That was powerful. Like those harmonizing in the background is pretty cool too. Oh, I love that kind of build up. It's so cool. Dang, it's striking. That was a good second track. I really enjoyed it. It was definitely hard hitting, definitely more of a power ballad. Love the kicks in it. So far it's 2 for 2, and it's gonna be 3 for 3 because Driver's License up next. This song is gonna be a classic, I can say that. A lot of people are gonna love this song for years. I can tell that. Here comes literally the bridge of our lives. So good, so good. So freaking beautiful, man. Oh, like I said, this song is just as beautiful as ever. A classic song, one of the best songs of the year, in my opinion. This one's one step forward, three steps back. Nice little guitar pattern here. Reminds me of something like Taylor Swift's Folklore a little bit. Just the instrumental vibe here. That's pretty catchy. I will say this. It did kind of have the same beat going the whole time. Kind of with that smooth guitar loop the whole time. And it was good. I'm not saying it was bad. But I'm kind of glad it kind of cut off at like 2.5 minutes. Because if this was a 4-minute song and it just had that loop, I kind of would have got annoyed. But it just stops it so I don't get annoyed right there. Yeah, that was one step forward, three steps back. It was pretty good, pretty catchy. This so far, I'm loving this album. Up next, we have Deja Vu, which is a single I heard. A little piano. That verse right there. hits it hard, man. This chorus is just so beautiful, because it's like saying, like, oh yeah, we did that too. When you guys have that, oh, it's like, and then, oh, that instrumental is so cool. What? That line, it's pretty cool. Usually a lot of people can't pull up playing celebrities on a song, but Olivia did it. Do you get a job for what she's with you? 5 songs we've heard so far. The bridges for all of them have just been insane, man. Madness. Like I said, that is like super lyrically like a burn on Josh. But this next song is Good For You, which is also another single. I was not expecting her to go pop punk on this track. It really builds up here. Guitar. Dude, the drummer, I swear. Dude, the guitars, the drums, the bass, everything about this track is so good. I was not expecting like a full punk song at all. I forgot about this. That just brought me back to like the 2000s punk, man, Avril Lavigne. It was like Paramore. Let's continue with this album. We have a couple more, 5 more tracks on here, and they're all new. So let's do this. This next one is Enough For You. Alright, coming in with that ballad guitar again. Really pretty. She's got some good skills on the guitar here. Especially with those vocals. Oh, it's still going, okay. Dang. Powerful. Holy crap. That was beautiful. Lyric-wise, again. Oh my goodness. That guitar pattern over those beautiful vocals. It was just so sad, so deep, you know what I'm saying? This next one is called Happier. Nice. That's brutal, man. That's brutal. I like at the end when it felt like it was gonna blow up and it just stopped. That was really cool. I did like the bass off that track. I thought the lyrics were also amazing as ever. So, got a couple more tracks, got 3 more here. We got Jealousy up next here. Ooh. Nice little bass riff to you, okay. I kinda wanna throw my phone across the room. So comparison. What? Ooh. Little dancing vibe here going on here. What? A little depressed here. Not wanting to be yourself. What? That was sick. Definitely groovy and catchy. Dancy, summer, boppy, catchy, whatever you want to call it. It was amazing. It's called Favorite Crime. Here. Okay, bring it on the guitar again. Faster. Beautiful. Ooh, okay. Your favorite crush. trying not to cry, man. I'm trying not to break. This album's been so good. Like, I don't think there's been a bad song off this album. And every song off here, oh my god, it's just been beautiful. This last song, Hope You're Okay. This might make me break if it's another power ballad like we just listened to.
You were a boy once when I was small, towhead blonde with eyes. If you're out there, I hope that you're okay.
Okay, oh, I see.
Okay.
Nice. It dropped.
That
was something. That was, oh my goodness. Well, this whole album, let me tell you, I don't think there was a bad song off this record. I don't think there were any real huge flaws off this record. This is darn near perfect record. This is definitely a contender for album of the year, and I definitely will be coming back to it a lot. Like, a lot, a lot. Every song off here just had great lyrics, the bridges, beautiful vocals, some dancey grooves, some power ballads, some striking rock. It was all mixed in there, and I loved it. One of the albums of the year. I'm gonna do my favorite tracks. I will still say Driver's License is up there just because it is very hard-hitting. Kind of gives me that chills. I was really happy. Jealousy was really good. I didn't like that kind of like, what is it, poppy summer kind of vibe it had to it. That was really cool. Favorite Crime as well. The kind of like metaphors on that was pretty sick. And I would have to say the first track, Brutal, would definitely be up there as well. I just love those guitars, and it's just a great intro to the album as well. And yeah, every song off this album was like a freaking banger, a freaking masterpiece nearly. I think the only problem I really had with it was there were a couple like guitar loops on some of the ballads that kind of just kept going, and I felt like they seem easily forgettable, but not too forgettable that I won't ever listen to them again. They just seemed like they were kind of there. She could have added some more emphasizing or whatever you call it to it, you know, amp it up. But yeah, I would definitely give Sour a 9.5 out of 10, one of the best albums of the year. Oh my goodness, so good.